Say, my master, increase me in knowledge. Not increase me in height. Some of us are short. They love to play basketball. They want a few extra feet. And some of us want, you know, their pocket to be longer so they can fit more money or their salary, which is fine, which is fine. But what was Allah, what did Allah command the Prophet ﷺ to ask for more? Knowledge. And say, my master, increase me in knowledge. Seeking knowledge. Learning the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an amazing reality. We must depend on Allah. The first thing is what? إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. If you seek Allah's aid, Allah shall facilitate it for you. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ. Allah said in the Quran, and fear Allah, be mindful of Allah, and Allah will teach you. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. O you who have believed, if you have taqwa of Allah, He will give you the criterion. You'll be able to see the wrong as wrong and leave it alone. The truth is truth and follow it. The right, the wrong, the good, the bad, everything will be clear like the sunshine for you. For other people, they're confused. But if you fear Allah, then this will become means. So, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. The second etiquette of seeking knowledge, as Dr. Yahya, may Allah bless him and reward him, we love him for the sake of Allah, had explained thoroughly, and there's no harm in reminding, because we all need the reminder, beginning with myself, moving on to you, is sincerity. You must do it for the sake of Allah. If you don't do it for the sake of Allah, it shall soon be put out. It will not last. It will not last. There will be some deficiency in the da'wah at some point in time. And this happens very often. When da'wah becomes a job. You see, it's beautiful to give da'wah, but not as a job. When it becomes a job, you know, when, as again, I can't help but build on his statements, may Allah bless him. Imagine if you were working in a business and you have to sell something. You have to sell something, but you really don't care whether the customer buys it or not, but it's your job. The chances of you being a successful salesman are very, very low. Because you yourself, you're not entertained with the product. So if we don't have this sincerity, and da'wah becomes a job, habit, they bring in a Muslim, say, okay, you know, Allah is one, Jesus is not the Son of God, you know, blah, 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 blah. And when you're done, you know, okay, balik Islam, ready, give shahada. The brother doesn't understand anything, huh? He doesn't know, the whole time he was looking at the, you know, at the wall. You're talking, then you want to become Muslim, you're ready for shahada. And sometimes, you know, he says, yeah, sure, what do I have to lose? And he will enter into Islam. When do you realize that there was something wrong? When he joins the classes. And, you know, people like Dr. Yahya, when they teach the people, they realize that he still believes that Jesus is God. And then you say, hold on, man, who gave this person da'wah? Maybe someone who thought da'wah was a job. There was no sincerity. We must know what we're doing. Ya akhi, for someone to leave his religion, you know better. How many of you are balik Islam? Raise your hand. MashaAllah. The majority. It's not easy. It's not easy to leave alone the religion that you've always adhered to. The religion of your parents. The religion of your community. The religion of your country. And go to a religion which in the media is the worst religion. You don't find them saying anything about Hinduism or Buddhism. Anything, everything is good. Even an atheist is good for them. Where do they have a problem? With whom? With Muslims. Anywhere you go. So for you to leave a religion which is popular and come to a religion which is not very popular in the media, this is a very difficult move. It's not easy. So why do you expect it to be easy for other people if it wasn't easy for you? Unless Allah made it easy for you. So then we need to keep in mind that this is a da'wah, this is a relationship with Allah. When I'm speaking to this person, I want to please Allah, I want to save him from the fire, I want to save myself, I want to fulfill the obligation of giving da'wah. It's not a job. Just finish quickly, Allah give shahada, and then the next day brother say, alhamdulillah, now I have 14 shahada. You're keeping track? Do you get a receipt? You tell me, have you ever given da'wah? Someone became a Muslim, then all of a sudden from the heaven, you know, from the sky, a receipt came down. Says, congratulations, Mr. Ahmed, your da'wah has been accepted by Allah. If you ever receive this one, you're playing with the shayateen. No way. You don't know. And Allah described the true believers, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. Those who put forth the deed which they put forth, and their hearts are trembling, shaking, that they will return to Allah. What does that mean? Aisha radiallahu anha said to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, is this the man who is a Muslim, but he commits fornication, he drinks alcohol, he steals? He said, La ya bint al-Siddiq. La ya bint al-Siddiq, no, daughter of Abu Bakr. It is the Muslim who prays, and he pays zakah, and he fasts, but he doesn't know whether Allah accepted his deed or not. He's doing all kinds of good deeds, but he's always worried. Was that accepted by Allah? So this keeps you in track. Once you feel that you're good, you're already falling back. If sincerity goes away, we turn it to a job, then we start bragging. I gave da'wah to so many people, so many people became Muslim through me. Brother, never say that. If Allah guides 50,000 people to Islam through you, the best thing for you is that no one knows but Allah. Because once it goes out and you start feeling you want to get praise, the rice is bad. Pancit with no rice. Not a good dinner. You must ensure that the people are not entertained. Now people may like it, alhamdulillah, but you with Allah always have to check this gauge. You know, like the car, you're driving to Mecca and you on empty, you always have to check the gauge. Or the temperature, maybe your car overheats like mine. You know, as soon as you turn on the car, it's already all the way up. Especially now in the heat. You have to check the gauge of ikhlas. Where is it going? Is it going up or going down? The gauge of knowledge. How long have you been on empty? How long have you known the same ayah, same hadith? Every time you give a lecture, same stuff. إِنَّنِي أَنَا اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا أَنَا فَاعْبُدْنِي وَأَقِمِ الصَّلَاةَ لِذِكْرِي. طب الحمد لله, you memorize this ayah. أو بعدين, we have 6,000 some ayah in the book of Allah. Can we depend on one ayah? Is it enough? No, it's not. You have to learn more. You have to memorize more. In Arabic, in English, in Tagalog, whatever language you speak, you must be able to give the people Islam with textual evidence. Allah said that in the Qur'an. The Prophet ﷺ said that. When the person who hears you, listens to you, he will become traumatized. See, this is a big, big shot. You may be tiny like me, small size. But when you sit with a non-Muslim and he hears you, he doesn't even know a verse in the Bible. You tell him, you know, for God so loved the world. Which verse? He doesn't know it's John 3:16. You know it's John 3:16. The Christian doesn't. So to him, you are like a giant. You're a mountain. And so this is da'wah. But when he tells you something, you're like, yeah, I don't know. Shh, big problem. Now, it may happen, but we don't want to remain at this level. Maybe you are at this level now, you're new. But you can't stay like this for many years, brother. Once you get into the da'wah, you must move with the crowd. You must step on the gas and take off, insha'Allah ta'ala. Thirdly, the heart. Purifying the heart. Allah Azza wa Jalla had warned, وَلَقَدْ ذَرَأْنَا لِجَهَنَّمْ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ لَا يَفْقَهُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ أَعْيُنٌ لَا يُبْصِرُونَ بِهَا وَلَهُمْ آذَانٌ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا أُولَئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْ هُمْ أَضَلُّ أُولَئِكَ هُمُ الْغَافِلُونَ. جزاك الله خير. شكرا حبيبي. And verily we have designated for the hellfire many among the humans in the jinn. What is their quality?